Using Mocha's object brush and matte assist inside Continuum's Pixel Chooser opens up a huge range of possibilities for us. My name is Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects, and here are my top 10 tips for getting the most out of these AI-powered masks. Let's start off with a focus on the UI. If you're using the Essentials workspace, you'll now find that there's two tabs, Track and Mask, conveniently located in the main Essentials tab. The track functionality is focused on planar tracking and manual spline masks, as it's always been, and the Mask tab is where you'll find the new AI-powered auto mask propagation tools. Number 2. A lot of the time we're going to be selecting people. Here's some tricks for using Object Brush for selecting humans. If you want a mask that includes the head, always start with the head. This is the best initial trigger for humans. To select the entire body, add one green dot on the head and another on the body near the bottom of the screen or person. If the object brush ever takes in too much detail, simply right-click to add a holdout dot to start excluding the other highlighted areas. For individual body parts, click on the desired part. If other areas of the body or skin are also selected, right-click to add a few holdout dots until only the intended part remain. Don't be tempted to add too many though, I'll show you another trick in a moment. And if you want multiple people, create a separate layer for each of them. It'll make the process easier with fewer adjustments later. And my tip number 3. Crucially, it's best practice to always finalize your object brush shape before activating matte assist. Click on the finish button or change back to the arrow pick tool. You can click on the render button right from the object brush, but you lose the opportunity to clean up your mask before it's animated across the frame. For tip number 4, you don't always have to use the AI powered tools. If a clean selection with the object brush proves difficult, use the area brush add tool to refine the shape. Creating a stroke will add to the mask, but if I hold down the Alt key, I can change the brush to remove areas selected by my object brush. Remember that the tool you're using matters. Revert to the object brush to automatically set up the correct frame options. Tip number 5 is all about cleanup. For any remaining small extraneous splines, either select all points with the pick tool and press delete, or select any point in the spline, right-click and choose spline, delete spline. A well-defined initial shape significantly improves the results of matte assist. And here's number 6. Matte assist propagation isn't limited to object brush layers. It works with any layer. Simply ensure that generate object matte is enabled. And right-click on the spline and click single frame on before rendering out the matte assist. Conversely, object brush layers aren't restricted to matte assist. Standard planar tracking is also an option. Keep in mind that the object brush initially creates a single frame spline. To track across the entire shot, right-click on the spline, turn single frame off, then in the mask tab, disable generate object matte, and you'll be able to track through using the regular planar tracking. Tip number 7 is about getting you to relax with the results. The splines created with the object brush and those generated by matte assist are distinct and not pixel perfectly aligned. Don't worry if they don't totally match, they're not going to. Here's an important one for tip number 8. Matte assist splines are not directly editable. If the results aren't accurate enough for you, consider adding more reference frames or supplementing them with traditional Mocha splines. Pixel perfect accuracy is not always guaranteed with matte assist. If you need subpixel precision, rely on Mocha's traditional roto masking tools. Tip number 9 is all about what to do if you don't have a solid spline line anymore. A dotted line on your matte assist shape indicates a change since the last render. The mask will still work even though it's dotted, and if that's okay, no action is needed. Be aware that re-rendering the matte assist might create a new result that calculates those changes. And tip number 10. If the matte assist isn't rendering as expected, check that generate object matte is enabled. Similarly, if your spline isn't tracking correctly with regular Mocha planar tracking, ensure that generate object matte is turned off. The layers window displays the status of this setting. The silicon chip looking matte button signifies that AI-powered mats are active. Those are my top 10 tips. If you've got any of your own, then drop them in the comments below. And that's why I want to see your questions as well. My name's Ben Brownlee for Boris Effects. I'll see you again soon.